Hello guys, welcome back to TechsConnect, and this video is all about rapier weaving. Let's see what is a rapier and what are the different types of rapiers, and also what is the mechanism involved. So we've already seen projectile weaving machine, which comes under shuttleless weaving. Similarly, rapier is one such type of shuttleless weaving techniques, which uses a rapier to insert weft into the shed across the loom. So this is how a rapier loom looks like, and these are the rapier heads, which are actually concerned with the gripping and the yarn transfer, which eventually results in picking. Rapier machines have good performance and versatility, so we can weave a wide range of fabric, that is from 20 GSM to 850 GSM, where GSM is grams per square meter. If you are not well versed with this term, go watch our video on GSM Explained, link of which is given in the description below. Alright, coming down, it is used for household as well as industrial fabric and has a good weft insertion rate. Okay, so now you have got a basic idea that there is a thing called rapier loom, which has rapier heads and which transfer the yarn. Bas wahi kaam jo ek shuttle ya projectile karta hai. Now before we begin and see the mechanism and have a look at exactly what's happening, let's go through the types of rapier so it will be easy for us to understand. The types of rapiers are single rigid, double flexible and double telescopic. Let's start with single rigid. Now this is actually a solid composite rod like material which carries the filling yarn from one end and passes it across the shed. Its length has to be equal or slightly greater than the width of the weaving machine, as you can see in the video. So as the name suggests, here a single rapier that is rigid is responsible for the picking to take place. The disadvantage is that more of a floor space is required, as when the rapier is not in the shed, it requires equal amount of space to rest outside, that increases the length. This is not very popular, but it is suitable for filling yarns that are difficult to control. Coming down to double rigid rapier. This has two rapiers in use, one is called the giver and the other is called the taker. Both of them travel only half the distance of the loom shed. Giver takes the filling yarn from the yarn accumulator, brings it to the center and then transfers it to the second rapier or the taker, which takes it completely to the other side of the loom. Now if we look at the double flexible rapier, we can see that the mechanism of the weft transfer is just the same. But difference is, instead of a rigid material, it uses a flat metal tape which is flexible. It can be anything made up of high-tech composite material. Now what is the advantage? The flow space, which was a problem in rigid rapier, is now reduced. As the rapier is flexible, it is coiled into a circular sheath, which of course requires less space. Also, these rapiers are much lighter, so the speed increases. Similarly, the fourth and the last type is the double telescopic rapier, which uses sliding telescopic devices for the picking to take place. Now, as they are telescopic, much of the length is stored in the rapier themselves. So again, the width of the loom is reduced. But there's a disadvantage as well. Due to the weight of the rapier and the time required for the extension and the contraction, it can only reach to a maximum speed of 350 picks per minute. That is a bit slow. Alright, so let us again have a look at what's happening in a rapier machine so it will be easy for us to clear all of our doubts. Two rapiers come from each side, that is a giver and the taker, and thus takes the yarn across the shed. Okay, so let us move on to different weft transfer systems. Number one, Devas, which is tip to tip transfer, and the second one is Gabler, that is loop transfer. So in Devas system, pay close attention. The giver grips the tip of the yarn and transfers it to the taker, which retracts and the yarn is carried to the other side. as shown in the image below. Whereas in the Gabler system of wave transfer, the yarn is not gripped. The giver takes the yarn in form of a U-shaped loop to the center of the machine, just like as shown in the second stage of the diagram. And then the taker extends the yarn to the other side of the machine. And this is how the weft is transferred. Yeah, so this was it from my side. Hope you guys have got a basic idea about rapier weaving machine. Stay tuned as we come up with more such videos. Until then, stay safe and stay healthy.